Today we are going to discuss what are silent receptors. Silent receptors are those receptors which when combined with the agonist does not produce any type of response. Silent receptors are those receptors which when combined with the agonist or which when combined with the drug does not produce any type of response. They are also called as a acceptor site or non-specific binding site. What are the other names for the silent receptors? They are also called as acceptor sites. Silent receptors are the acceptor sites or non-specific binding sites. And examples of silent receptors are drug absorbed on the plasma proteins. So, plasma proteins are the best examples of the silent receptor. Plasma proteins act as a silent receptors. Means, we have discussed in the lecture of plasma protein binding that the drugs which is in a bound form, means drug which is bound to the plasma proteins, they act as a temporary reservoir of a drug. Means, those drugs which is in a bound form, they are not available for action, they are not available for metabolism, and they are not available for excretion. That means plasma proteins are silent receptor. Means these are the receptors which when combined with the drug, it does not produce any response. Now here you can see what are silent receptors. Means when agonist bind to the plasma protein binding or silent receptor, there is no response, no biological activity or no response. When chronic use of a drug, when there is a chronic use of a drug, normal receptors in a target organs are blocked. What happens when we use a drug for the prolonged period? Normal receptors in a target organs are blocked. Some of the silent receptors become active. Okay, when chronic use of drug, normal receptors in the target organs are blocked and some of the silent receptors become active, and that's why there is a reason why there is a development of tolerance. Tolerance develops, and when the drug is withdrawn, silent receptors remain active along with the normal active receptors, no longer blocked. So increase in the number of active receptors, and that's why there is a withdrawal symptoms or rebound hyperactivity. And this is the clinical relevance in the drug tolerance and drug dependence. Now what is the importance of silent receptors? We'll see one more time. This agonist, when it is combined with the silent receptor, there is no response that we have seen. But when we use any drug for a longer period of time, normal receptors in that target organs are blocked. Now some of the silent receptors become active. When the normal receptors in the target organs are blocked, tolerance develop. And when the drug is withdrawn, silent receptors remain active along with the normally active receptors, no longer blocked. That's why there is increase in the number of active receptors, right? That's why there is a increase in the number of active receptors, and that leads to the withdrawal syndromes or withdrawal symptoms and rebound hyperactivity or super sensitivity of the receptors. So this is the clinical relevance in the drug tolerance and drug dependence.